Hi, let's learn how to make 3D fractals of regular solids using Blender geometry nodes. You'll be using Blender 2.93 and Blender 3.0. First, I want to go over what we're going to be making. You can feel free to skip this if you want. The timestamps for where the tutorial starts are on the screen. We're going to be using a dodecahedron. We can take 20 dodecahedrons and make a new composite shape that neatly fits inside of the previous dodecahedron. This now makes the basic geometry we're going to use to separate the shape further. If we replace each of those 20 dodecahedrons with 20 more dodecahedrons, we get this shape. If we repeat this step one more time, we get this shape. We can keep going, but I find it often starts to slow down my computer after I've done this about 4 times, so I've chosen not to. The process is much more tedious in Blender 2.93 than in Blender 2.3 because the geometry nodes in Blender 2.3 work a little bit different. The way we essentially make the fractals is by instancing geometry on each of the points. In Blender 2.93, you can only instance separate objects around the geometry the tree is working on. However, in Blender 2.3, we can actually instance the original geometry onto itself. This makes the process significantly easier and more procedural. Before we get started, I'm going to enable a built-in plugin that allows me to create regular solids. The plugin is called Extra Objects. Again, you don't need to download anything. This comes with Blender. Also, obviously, use Node Wrangler. Now let's jump into the 2.93 version of the tutorial. Once we have our dodecahedron, we actually need to make a copy of it. I'm going to rename my first copy Fractal 1 and my second object Instance. Now select Fractal 1, go to the Geometry Nodes tab and add a new tree. I'm going to call this Fractal 1 2. Add a point instance node to the tree, and now where it says object, select our instance object. You'll notice the dodecahedrons are too big and we'd probably like to scale them down. Add a point scale node. It's a little bit tedious to input all those values manually, so let's add a value node and the combined XYZ node. Plug the values into the X, Y, and Z, and then plug this into the factor or point scale. The best scale to use for the dodecahedron is 0.62, but for different shapes, the number will be different. You'll also notice that the shape as a whole is a bit larger than the original dodecahedron, and as we continue the process, the shape will continue to get larger. To fix this, let's plug the scale we used earlier into the scale of a transform node, and now it should be the size we wanted. Now the tedious part. On Blender 2.93, to achieve the look we want, we have to duplicate this object and set it to the size. Rename it Fractal 2. Now go into the geometry nodes and click the copy button. Rename the tree Fractal 2 as well. We now need to select Fractal 1, and we should get the right result. You'll repeat the step until you get the desired shape. Now you might have seen this video by Khamurai where he uses the same node group and just duplicates it in the modifier stack. This works for the type of fractals he made in his tutorial, and if you like this tutorial, you should try that one out too. But his solution in both versions of Blender had the same problem that bugged me here. I want all of this to just be in one node group so I can have it all in one place. Luckily, in Blender 2.3, we can just use one node tree. Quick note, if you're gonna use this in the future, your version of Blender might look a little bit different than this because I'm using 2.3 beta, but it should still be possible to complete the tutorial. We're going to add an instance on points node and then a transform node. We're gonna plug in the input geometry into both the points and instance, and we can look at the output. Since everything is a little big, just like in 2.93, add a value node and a combined XYZ node, plug the values into the X, Y, and Z, and then plug the vector into the scale. You'll again notice the shape is a bit larger than the original dodecahedron, and as we continue the process, the shape will continue to get larger. To fix this, let's plug the scale we used earlier into the scale of the transform node, and now it should be the size we wanted. We can now select the instance to points node and the transform node, and press Ctrl G to create a node group. We can delete one of the scale inputs since they're the same, replug it in, and then press tab to exit from the group view. From now on, it's up to you. You can duplicate the node group as many times as you want to change how many divisions show up. Make sure you plug the original geometry into the point each time, and then plug in the previous output of the node group into the instance. This is so that each time we make new geometry, it's instanced around the original points of the dodecahedron. And you're done! I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and thank you so much for watching.